Welcome back. Definitely a jungle. Friday's the day. I'm Jim Rome. It's an epic Friday. This is the Great American Smack Off. The aftershocks from the brick scud are still shaking our building a little bit. So if we start to shake in the middle of the next segment, you'll know what it is. It's an aftershock. Going to the fax machine. I told you Bill from Orange had five different categories, which I read before. And he's been scoring this thing the entire show. Doc Mike, 7.4. Ross from PB, 7.4. Loyalist Steve, 7.2. On and on. Trollman, he's reading DQ. Andre in San Diego, 7.0. And then he gets to the brick and he writes in giant letters, "Forget it, it's over." This fact says, two epic Van Smack, game over. The jungle seems to think the contest is over after JT the Brick scud. Now, I would not end it yet. We still have some legends to come. I see Adam and PB finally decided to call. We'll get him up shortly. There are some others. Irate Craig still has not called. Julius from Camp Pendleton, who has a 10-year exemption, still has not called. Nate in San Diego is getting ready. And here, our first celebrity smack. Well, he's not really a celebrity. He's more jungle dweller than celebrity, but I've been watching the box scores. He's been putting in quality minutes. The guy has smack like no other. He has white hair. It's Buck. Roebuck Tolbert in the jungle. Buck, what is up?
What is up?
Buck, no way we could have a great American smack off without you coming in to get off your scud.
It's definitely impossible. Definitely impossible.
All right, now before you get ready to launch that pup, how about it, man? You were playing some good basketball. It's good to see you in the box scores.
Well, let me just tell you something. Last game, 5 minutes, 4 points, four rebounds. If you prorate that through 48 minutes, you're talking all-star numbers.
Oh, that was like a month for you. I couldn't believe it.
It's unbelievable. I can kick back for four games now and just think, it's all gravy. It's all gravy from here on out.
And not only that, but I went looking for you last night. Apparently, you're in a suite.
Oh, yeah.
What happened to the hotel room?
You know, when you start putting up numbers like that, they treat you a little better.
When you start getting 5 minutes a game, forget it.
Oh, yeah.
Sweet room service, the whole shot.
It's all over. It's all over. They didn't pay for my room service, so it's incredible.
Now, Buck, let me ask you this. Is this just your typical call to the jungle, or do you understand the magnitude of the Great American Smack Off? It might be somewhat embarrassing if one of these clones took you down.
I wouldn't worry about that. You know, there's always things in the back of my head that really upset me.
See, what you're trying to tell me is
things I don't need.
So, like, we'll get to that in 1 second, but you're trying to tell me that on any given day when you wake up and you're kind of bitter, somewhat irritable, you think you can win a contest of this nature on any given day just by being who you are?
Not even irritable. All I got to do is think of things that make me upset. And every sports fan can relate with things that make you upset. So you just unhook the reins. The list isn't quite as expansive as it was last time, but a couple of things that upset me.
All right, tell you what, Buck, let me get out of the way. So far, we are 13 calls in. You were number 14. You are our first celebrity in the Smack Off on this epic Friday. So I'm out. Go ahead. Let it rip.
All right. As they say, let's get ready to rumble. Back in the jungle, baby. Give you a little dose of things that you just don't need. You know, I really don't need every team trying to incorporate black into their colors, okay? It's getting a little sickening. Even the gangsters aren't wearing it anymore. They're going, hey, everybody's wearing this stuff. When you see a 29-year-old yuppie wearing a black Los Angeles Dodgers cap, cut your losses, okay? I don't need fans calling into sports radio talk shows saying, you know, I'm not even going to watch another baseball game. I'm not going to go to another baseball game. I'm not even going to sit on my TV couch and watch another baseball game. Yeah. When you get home with your big beer gut and you stick your Salisbury steak, Swanson TV dinner into the microwave, it pops out piping hot, you go sit on the TV with your cold one, put your TV dinner in your beer gut, what are you going to watch? Another rerun of Full House? I don't think so. You're going to click on the baseball game, you're going to be bitter at yourself, but you're going to do it. You know what would be cool? If everyone banned the ballpark for opening day. Is that too much to ask? They put you, the true sports fans, through hell. Last year, no season in the pennant races, no playoffs, no World Series. Just for one day, one stinking day, let's see how they would like it playing in front of just a bunch of empty wooden seats and some cockroaches. And no, I don't mean the owners. I mean the insects. I don't need people buying five BMWs. I don't need people thinking OJ's still innocent. I don't need athletes who talk in the third person. So Chris Webber, how'd you like the trade going from Golden State to Washington? Well, you know, Chris Webber really enjoyed the trade, and Chris Webber's just trying to settle down, and excuse me, aren't we talking to you? We need Chris Webber. Is there two of you guys? What are you, like, Roseanne now? You have, like, 19 different personalities? Come on, give me a break. I don't need Bo Jackson, the actor. I barely needed Bo Jackson, the two-star athlete. I don't need him as an actor. I don't need baseball purists. What is this, some sort of elite group, baseball purists? What's so exciting about one pennant race in the middle of September when three of the rest of the divisions are already decided? And, you know, as a matter of fact, baseball is so pure that it's the only sport that would let a seven-time repeat offender of cocaine use play in its pristine game. Interesting. I don't need Tim McCarver doing Pep Boy commercials. Manny Moe and Tim? I don't think so. Where's Dion with his bucket of ice when we need him? I don't need a Turk floating in my toilet when I check into my hotel room. Jeez, I really don't need that. I don't need owners complaining, hey, you know, I need a salary cap. My team's losing money every year. Well, here's an idea. Sell the team. And here's another idea for you. Don't worry about the talent. Get a good coach and teach some of these high-paid sports clowns some fundamentals. That's right, I said it. Fundamentals. Nah, that'd be too easy. I don't need Michael Jordan taking all my boy Steve Kerr's shots. I don't need scoring updates telling me that the Knicks are leading the Magic 4-2 with 11:45 left in the first quarter. What is that? And on a closing note, I don't need any more comparisons to Hawk and Lube. Good night now.
I don't need Michael Jordan taking any more of my boy Steve Kerr's shots. Outstanding blast, Buck. Good to have you in the smack-off. I knew we could not have a smack-off without Tom Tolbert. I will never forget the first time Buck Tolbert called the jungle. This guy's sitting around, being a Tolbert, not getting minutes. Bulldog hits me in my ear. Yo, Tom Tolbert wants to be on the show. I said, Tom Tolbert. He said, yeah, Tom Tolbert. Oh, you mean that slug with the Clippers? He said, yeah. I said, what does he want? He wants to be on the show. Ever since then, the jungle has not been the same. The guy runs smack from anywhere, anytime, at any point. And we definitely need Buck Tolbert. Good scud. Good call. Now, remember, we're trying to be as objective as possible about the jungle. You can't home, you can't go for your favorites. You're looking at smack in its purest form. Celebrities are not favored over anybody else. What do you think? How does that measure up? Keep your faxes coming. If you're looking for the fax number, you want to score along, get your input in, we'll go ahead and take it. Phone number's toll free, 800-470-SMACK. If you can't get through on that line, try this one. Area code 213-464-6289. Vegas, before you go to OJ Radio, hear me out on this. This is the sort of thing we're looking for from you people. Next week when you start calling the show, that's what we're looking for. Denver, Nug Puppies, this is what we want. Albuquerque, you're starting to get the drift. I know you are. Rochester comes in on Monday. I want to hear from all you people. That's part of the reason we're doing this. And I want to have a King of Smack via the phone lines. I want somebody to reign supreme. We'll take a time out. We'll come back. Still to come, Adam in Pacific Beach, Nate in San Diego, and a few others. We'll update you on what's going on so far, maybe get a couple of faxes out there. I might even mix in a sports note before too much longer. Great to be with you. This is Epic Friday. It's the Great American Smack Off. I'm Jim Rome, and this is the Noble Sports Radio Network.